Comedy for the money is kind of like getting into Dungeons and Dragons for the sex. That's call. So living in this area has been very difficult. I'm trying to ways to make extra money while I'm here to get by. Like one idea I had, I was reading up on like food from other cultures. I read that some countries eat donkey burgers, which is something I've never heard of. Never seen a donkey burger restaurant in the United States. I want to open up the first one, and I want to call it Ass to Mouth. Make your reservations early. An intimate night with your loved one, guys. Things have actually been going better than you'd think. Like in the lady department for me, despite the fact that I look like I write Lord of the Rings erotic fan fiction. It's actually going okay. In fact, recently I think I found the perfect song to play during a threesome. I think it's got to be Randy Newman's You've Got a Friend in Me. I love going out and seeing live music. It's a big part of my life. I haven't been going as much recently because a few years ago I went to a festival, see some bands I wanted to see, should have looked into it more because also on the bill unbeknownst to me was Nickelback. Yeah, I didn't want to see Nickelback. And I was stuck in the masses, no way out, nowhere to go for like over an hour. And then a sign language interpreter on stage with them the entire performance. Oh, and all they did was this. Bad ditties. Does anyone ever smoke electronic cigarettes? Anybody will ever admit this at a show?
Do you?
Yeah, you great bastard. Hell yeah. I like that. I get like mad when I bring them up. I don't get, whenever I think of e-cigs, I just think of like two robots smoking those in bed after sex, you know? Maybe tragically over time, when those robots smokes one too many electronic cigarettes, that's gonna hold, cut in its robot neck, put a blue socks up, and it's not human. That doesn't happen to most comedy shows. You guys are nice people. Hell yeah. Oh, man. You know what I think robot sex would smell like? Yeah, I've been thinking about it. You ever held on to a bunch of pennies for a while? Same disturbing odor of wet copper. I'm a big fan of movies. I like horror movies a lot, especially like ghost flicks. And something I've noticed when I'm watching those almost every single time, the hauntings are happening inside of like a gigantic mansion or an estate. It's always like a huge home. It's never like a studio apartment or a duplex. And I think there should be more affordable haunted housing. I don't like that wage disparity in the scare. I don't think poor people should have to go to goddamn cornfield this day. Poor people have the same opportunities for scares and spooks. Yeah, right. I'm going to be a one-issue man. It's going to be affordable haunted housing, goddamn. Some changes up in this motherfucker. Goddamn. I'm going to be honest with you, you guys seem like a fun audience that I can divulge something I'm into sexually with you guys. It's not very popular nowadays. I enjoy a nice lush bush on a lady. You're chuckling. Thank you.
Hell yeah, you're twirling your hair. Thank you. You guys like muttered like, ew.
And I'm like, fuck that, I will wade through the swampy marshes of womanhood, okay? I don't navigate the fertile vegetation of the female Everglades aboard my lover craft. In these strips, I'm talking about farmer's market bush, alright? I'm talking about mason jar of kombucha bush. Like, still mad about Bernie Sanders bush. That's the legend I'm talking about. Then I wonder why, like, why is that something I like? Am I just narcissistic? Do I just want to get on my knees, pull down some panties, have my own face staring back at me? Look into a moist mirror or some shit? I don't know. I did something recently I'd never done before. I didn't think I could afford to do. I went to the horse races in Berkeley. Because I heard they have something called Dollar Days there.
Yeah,
every day! On Sundays. And you can go, like, everything's a buck, like beers, mimosas, yeah, hot dogs. So it's this crazy juxtaposition of like highbrow and lowbrow on that shit. There's people that are like super fancy, like nice big hats and like suits and things like that. And then characters like me with mustard in their shoe, swilling Miller High Life, bet on a horse because his name is Golden Donut, not know what the hell's going on. It's an awesome time in the process. And I want to see more things like that in other areas of culture. I think it'd be amazing to go to the opera one day and see something like this.
Thank you for coming to enjoy Leon Cabello's tragic masterpiece, Pagliacci. But don't forget about our late night Saturday opera. We'll be bringing you Paul Verhoeven's 1987 action classic
in a whole new way with RoboCopra.
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
Be a statue, Alex Murphy.
We've suffered a crisis, things will be fine.
Look out, it's at 209.
You have 10 seconds to comply, and if you don't, I will make you die.
RoboCop!
I buy that for a dollar.
And you will buy that for a dollar, because our late night menu was corn dogs and jello shots for $1.
I'm glad the 4th of July is over, personally. I'm not a huge fan of, like, most holidays. The only holiday we get, like, really excited about is Halloween. Like, candy, costumes, no obligations to hang out with your family. And I have a tradition I do every single year in Halloween. I go out, I get hammered. When people ask me what I am, I say my father. And then I dress up like a can of Coors Light just so it'll hold me. That's the only beer my dad ever drank, old Coors Light. I never understood it. I think it's a shitty drink. I don't like it. Maybe it's because it's always on sale, it's available everywhere, or he might have been swayed by advertising. Like, I once saw a statement on a bottle of Coors Light I'll never forget. It said, experience the legendary taste. What the fuck are these legends, guys? What could they be?
Odin! Thrust his staff through the heart of the snake head seductress Medusa, and then chugged a cold, crisp Coors Light. The mighty Thor swung his hammer and parted the seas with Poseidon beside him. And then a beck of cold, delicious, Coors Light. The Son of God, Jesus of Nazareth, attended the wedding party in Galilee. When their alcoholic libations had run dry, Christ performed his, dare I say, most refreshing miracle. It can be water, not so boring.